Hello, investors. I come to you today and got a new seven stock set to explode, set for 6-9. I'm so excited with how this has been going, and of course, I appreciate any of your support. If you could hit that most amazing like button at the end of this video, hopefully this list is of great value to you. And please subscribe and then set up notifications so you can get notified when new videos come out. And I'll just kind of keep these coming, and one right after the other. So every day I try to do a new stock picks for the next day. And then also at the end of the trading day, do a recap video, kind of how did we do kind of thing. So make sure and subscribe so that you can get all those videos. I'm so excited and so happy that you've given me your support by watching these videos. All right, new top seven list. We've had a terrific Monday so far, and I expect Tuesday for continuation to happen. Also, Friday and Thursday of last week was really terrific also. Just been really profiting off the stock market and so excited with how things are going. It's good that the economy is turning right around. And, you know, I'll be watching for weakness, obviously, in the market. But as far as this goes, I mean, I say invest, 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 invest. Let's go. Things have been just really been going great. So let me just get right into it. Number seven, and number seven has been lucky for whatever reason here lately. The number seven pick is the one that goes nuts. So it'd be kind of interesting to see tomorrow if indeed that is the case, if that continues. It's kind of a fun trend. I hope it does continue. I think it's neat. So anyway, my number seven pick is REZI. REZI. So Resi, it had terrific insider activity today by multiple directors, and all in open market, all large sums of money. So I'm excited about it. Can't wait to get in it. Haven't not been able to buy very much here yet. It is skyrocketed in aftermarket, and but I'll be looking for a good entry point for tomorrow. And anyway, Resi is the first one. I expect to do really well. Hopefully it's on the list for a couple days and it gets us a nice clean run up, but we're gonna buy with catalysts and let the indicator show when it's time to maybe move on. So anyway, that's the first one. Number six is EPZM. It is still on the list, so it's number six. It's not been climbing very much, but we are seeing increasing volume on this one, so I'm expecting that to continue and for it to even get further and further along as it gets going. The PDUFA date is coming up later this month, and I believe it's got a very good chance of getting approved, but I mean, again, I really don't care if it gets approved or not. It's really about the run-up, and I believe there will be excitement on this stock as it continues to go, so I'm gonna be in. I'm just gonna hold and see what happens. So it should be very stable, a very stable run-up. It is undervalued, so EPZM I think is a great pick for a long ways to come. Now, my number five pick, I've been in and out of this guy. Love-hate relationship with NBRV. I'm in love with it again. So it does have an upcoming PDUFA date. The reason that's held this stock back is that they're, with everything going on in the world, it appears the FDA is not sending out their people to other countries to look at facilities. Well, with their upcoming PDUFA date, one of their manufacturing facilities that really needs to be toured is in Europe. Well, that's a problem. So there is speculation that this could be delayed, but there are just too many good catalysts for NBRV for me to stay out. I keep watching it. I keep seeing its volume. And I think it's just about to go. It just needs any type of news that's positive. Just the littlest amount of news, just the little small thing. They could go on there and say, we've come up with a new foot fungus, and this thing would go nuts. So NBRV is, it's just set to go. So this list is called the seven stocks set to explode. So hey, NBRV is set to explode. So I like it, I'm in it, and I'm going to ride it for a little while. Hopefully we get some sort of news and it can go somewhere. Okay, number four, this stock, I was in it last month, and this thing went from $2.50 to $10 a share on insider activity. The stock I'm talking about is SRNE. Now, some people may not like Sorrento Therapeutics. They came out with a They came out with quite the claim. They said that they have solved C virus inside a Petri dish. And so now there's a lawsuit being fought against them. But this stock is a tremendous value. You know, analysts are saying it's worth $20 a share, $24 a share. There's tons of analysts out there. This thing has dropped all the way down in the fours. And I just could not ignore it anymore. Also, the other thing that's happening is BlackRock has purchased millions of shares. I pay attention when BlackRock buys, and so should you. So SRNE is set to explode. I mean, it's a $4 a share. I would not be surprised to see it hit by the end of the week. And this is kind of a bold claim, but $20 a share. I mean, this sucker, who knows what's gonna happen? But I'm in early, and I think you should get in early, and I think a nice run-up is coming. So anyway, pick number four is SRNE. And you know, people worry about the lawsuit, but I mean, you can't sue somebody if what they say is true. And I don't think BlackRock would be investing in this company if it wasn't true. There's just too many signs. And even if it's not, we ride the run-up, we watch for price action to weaken, and then we sell it, you know, and we make money. So anyway, I think the hype will take this up, and but I don't know. I don't know if they got the cure. Who knows? No one knows. You know, the only people that know are the insiders, I guess, and probably BlackRock. So if they're willing to put their money there, I'm willing to risk a little too. Number three, this one has dropped from the number one spot. It is not because I don't like it. It's just that, you know, it's only went up about 1.5% today, and that was highly unexpected for me. But Evoke, E-V-O-K, this has been on the list for a long time. I expect that it could explode at any moment. It's just one of those things where you see it being accumulated. And every day the volume is higher. And I like how it's just beating its average. And I just think a 20% pop is coming here soon. They have an upcoming PDUFA date. They have a high success probably of getting their drug approved. I think that other investors will think that it's got a high probability of getting approved. And for that reason, I think it will climb. Again, I do not like to hold stocks through PDUFA date. I typically like to sell them about a day beforehand. But that run-up is gonna happen. And so I think it's a great hold. Just hold it and see what happens. You know, here it goes. You know, you get in on a low price. It's got an upcoming catalyst, and that run-up is gonna be great. All right, number two, HCHC. This has been my little darling of a stock. Still undiscovered. I mean, go on StockTwits, it's got like, I don't know, 600 followers. What are you people not watching this stock for? Oh my gosh, the insider activity is intense. It keeps happening day after day. It's very, very strong. It's extremely bullish. This stock, I was able to get in at $3 a share, easy. And you know, 320, I was able to add a little bit more. It's up around 340 now, and this thing is going to go ballistic. And at some point, I would think that other people would pay attention to this, but this is on no one's list. And it's just because not enough people watch insider activity and know how to read the report. And so I highly recommend this stock. If you're not in it already, you know, this sucker's gonna run. It's gonna go. It's just a matter of time. I feel very strongly about that. Anyway, number one. This was number seven. Now it's number one. My favorite battery company, CBAT. Which is actually CBAC, but CBAT. So this thing is just going up. It's like a crazy bat flying. And anyway, I tried an analogy. It didn't work. But anyway, CBAT. So to my future editor out there, if you're watching this video, that would be the part where we have a little bat fly across the screen. You know, maybe it's got a tattoo on the side. It says CBAT, you know. Anyway, look for that. Look for great changes to the channel coming up shortly. And don't forget to hit that amazing and most wonderful like button. And then also please subscribe. And please turn on the notifications so that you get these videos first. Because you want to get in on these things first thing pre-market tomorrow. I mean, watch for a good entry point and then bam, get in there. Have money available to take advantage of these. But CBAT had insider activity that I call ridiculously bullish. So millions of dollars bought and in open market and at a very cheap valuation. This company is way undervalued. And I just think news is around the corner. Something's happening here. Today, I had a phenomenal day. It went up 50% today. You might think, but Ray, it's 50% up. I don't want it. I don't want to get in that. Well, I mean, I don't think it's done. I mean, it's possible we could see weakening factors tomorrow and there'd be a bunch of people sell off, you know, but I don't know. Maybe I think people right now with the market, they're greedy. They're going to be in it. The market's been up, been doing great things. It's a battery company. I think the oil, you know, gets a bad rap, you know, for not having a future, but a battery company that makes quality lithium ion batteries and other batteries and different things that they do, I just think that it's going to go crazy. So anyway, I'll be in it. I'll look for factors, you know, that tell me to sell it. And if they're there, we'll sell it, you know, but I think that it's a great investment. And so had insider activity last couple days. So anyway, that's the top seven list. I appreciate all of your support. And please reach out to me in the comment section below if you have any questions. I'm more than happy to answer any questions that you might have. Also, please like this video and subscribe. You know, I'd really like to get to 1,000 subscribers. I think it's possible. And, you know, help me get there. And anyway, have a wonderful night and good pre-order tomorrow, pre-market tomorrow, and get into some stocks and let's all make some money. What do you say? All right.